हेलो गाइस, दिस इज मसल राइडर एंड वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल वंस अगेन। सो दिस इज जस्ट एन ऑफिस कम्यूट एंड मेनी ऑफ द पीपल लेटली हैव बीन आस्किंग मी दैट हाउ डू आई गेट सो गुड फ्यूल इकोनॉमी ऑन माई स्पीड 400। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर यू सम टिप्स and tricks to get the good fuel economy. First let me see what I have set on the auto. I guess it's already set to the thing which I need to. Yeah, it's showing the real time mileage. So basically before starting the video, I usually get the mileage between 30 to 33 kilometers per liter when I calculated, and the worst which I get is around 28-29 in the heaviest of the traffic, but mostly it does show 34 kilometer per liter on the auto. Like look, right now it's showing 34. It does show 34 kilometers per liter on the auto, and yeah, it's pretty much accurate when I did calculate. So I'm gonna show you how I get the good fuel economy. So let's start with the video. Again, I'm going to set it to the real-time mileage so that you can see how it changes when I increase the throttle input. In the city, obviously you can't expect much because of the heavy traffic, but the first tip to get the fuel economy, good fuel economy in the traffic, is to give the bike minimum gas, minimum throttle inputs. Try to ride it on the clutch as much as possible. Look, right now I'm giving very minimal throttle, almost no throttle, and I'm living it on the first gear, and clutch is doing the work for me. Like, the bike has enough torque to pull me and herself. When I slot it in the first gear and I leave it on the clutch. So in the traffic, the rule is to give the minimal throttle and try to ride the bike mostly on the clutch when you are in the stop-go traffic. So now, once you hit the highway, I have just slotted the bike into the sixth gear. And the bike has enough torque, so it just can cruise from around 50 kmph to all the way around 170 kmph in the sixth gear. So that point also makes the bike give lot better fuel economy. So the concept on the highway remains the same. Rev the bike to the minimal, and when you are descending, the gravity is in your favor, so just let off the throttle, give minimal inputs to the throttle, and you will see the real time mileage of around 60 kmpl or something like that when you are off the gas. But again, that's a real time mileage, so don't consider it. Because it does keeps on changing depending upon your throttle inputs. But if you are riding sanely at around 4000 rpm at around 90 to 100 kmph, you can definitely receive a good fuel economy on your speed 400. And on the highways, it's literally very easy to get the good fuel economy because of the fat torque band which this bike offers. It is very easy to slot the bike into one single gear, like the sixth gear, and cruise it. Like right now I'm doing, I'm at 50 kmph, and bike is very smoothly pulling, maintaining its speed without any knocking issue, and also offering me the greatest of fuel economy. So it's very easy, like when you punch the bike, when you punch the throttle, you will see, you will notice that the fuel economy is dropping at very high pace, but then you try to settle the speed and it once again settles down to the very good number. Like right now I will show, I am at 80 kmph right now at sixth gear at around 3,500 RPM or something like that, and I'm receiving around 42 kmph on the real time. And if I try to overtake and punch the throttle to the max, like right now, the fuel economy drops insanely. So this is how it works basically. The more intense you are on the throttle, the less fuel economy you will get. More aggressive on the throttle, less fuel economy you will get. And if you are cruising at like decent speeds, 90-100 is also decent for our roads with the current condition, you will get a very good fuel economy. Right now look, I am using the gravity is in my favor, so the resistance is minimal, while the downhill or while descending the bridges, let's see how the fuel economy changes when I try to cruise on 100 kmph or something like that. Again, I'm not twisting the gas immediately, I'm gradually increasing the speed. So the concept here is basically to ride in the high gears at low revs. The more you ride on the lower gears at high revs, you will get low fuel economy, because the revs will start climbing very quickly. Next tip to get the good fuel economy is kind of mechanical tip, but you can always follow that. Always keep checking the chain slag of your motorcycle. If your motorcycle is a chain drive motorcycle, then you will always need to keep checking the chain slag after every 3 to 4 months, depending upon how aggressive you ride. If your sprocket is in good condition, the chain slag, the adjustment of the chain slag would remain constant for the long time. The more bad your sprocket condition is, you will need to keep adjusting the chain slack again and again. And next is the tire pressure. Always keep monitoring the tire pressure. If you are riding at very low PSI, the resistance will obviously increase and the bike will return you less fuel economy. And if you are riding at your recommended PSI, then obviously you will return a good fuel economy. I'm not remembering right now, but the recommended tire PSI of the Speed 400 is around 27 or 28 PSI at front and 33 PSI at rear. So always keep checking the PSI numbers, the tire pressure numbers. Not literally like daily, but at least once in a week if you are regularly riding. So the next step is, if you are stopping at the signal for more than 15 to 20 seconds, just turn off the bike. You will save a lot of fuel in this, because it's not worth keeping the bike idling at neutral at the stoplight if you are waiting for more than 15 to 20 seconds. If you are waiting less than 15 to 20 seconds, just keep the bike on, because cranking the bike again and again also decreases the fuel economy. The condition of the road right now is totally messed up, and plus due to the traffic and the bad road condition, the fuel economy is that was a good save. I guess only the scramblers and ADV motorcycles are supposed to survive on the Indian streets. There is no place for sports bike and roadsters or retro roadsters, something like that. If you're riding anything below 19 inch front, you are at the bad condition, guys. Even me, for that matter, I'm on the 17 inch front and rear wheel. The potholes are, the size of the potholes have grown crazily in past few years. In the every monsoon, I see a new pothole. So yeah, we got a bit diverted from the topic. If you are riding the Speed 400, you are very fortunate enough, because the bike has very good low end, so you can just keep the bike at the higher gears even in the slow speeds. Look, I am crossing the speed bump at 4th gear without engine knocking, and I have completely let off the clutch at 20 kmph. I can't even believe that. So if your bike has very good low end torque, you are very much fortunate enough. That's a added bonus to get good fuel economy. Even on the speed bumps, you will have to shift a minimal. Look, right now I'm at 5th gear and I was at 40 kmph. I even had to shift down till 4th or 3rd. Look again, I just slot that into 5th gear and I crossed the speed bump at 40 kmph. Smooth. So yeah, these were some of the tips and tricks to extract good fuel economy. Fuel economy also depends on the way you ride, the way you have maintained your vehicle, motorcycle, and it's not a hard and fast rule that it's only applicable for this bike, because I'm making the video on Speed 400. It's applicable to any vehicle, even car if you're driving. I drive an 2019 Ford Figo TDCi diesel Ford Figo. That car has an insane amount of torque, almost 215 Nm of torque, and in a very small and tight package. And on the best of the day, I get around 22 to 23 kmpl on the highway, and around 19 to 20 kmpl in the city. So it's all about the way you ride your vehicles and how you maintain it. So hope you found this video useful, guys. I will see you guys in the next vlog. Till then, ride safe and drive safe. Bye bye.